this gorgeous 2011 iMac still be good in 2022? In this video, we're definitely going to find out. So the model that we have here today is a 2011 iMac running Mac OS X with Core i5 CPU and 4 gigs of RAM, and it's rocking the original 500 gigabyte hard disk drive. Nice. One thing a lot of my clients complain about is the lack of support for the newer versions of Google Chrome on the older versions of Mac OS. Now we're going to upgrade this computer to a solid state hard drive and Monterey, but first let's see what the internet speed is actually like using the stock OS without any upgrades to the hardware or software. Okay, so let's head over to Google Chrome. And let's just do a few random searches. Let's go cooking. Not bad. Let's go houses. Nice. Let's go technology. I mean, decent for a computer from 2011. Let's head over to YouTube. YouTube's definitely struggling to open. Yeah. Let's open up my page. And let's just play whatever, random. Ad comes up. I mean, video looks pretty decent. Let's boost it up to 1080p. Let's go full screen. Definitely some lag and hesitation going to full screen, but I mean, once it's in full screen, seems like it's playing pretty fluently.
The backlit keyboard. I mean, visually, when you just look at this machine, it's absolutely gorgeous.
The sound is pretty good. Definitely, I would say, still usable. Let's open up Gmail. I mean, if you're just using internet browsing and you're okay with using the older version of Google Chrome, I think this computer would be okay. Let's head over to Apple. See how quick that webpage opens. I mean, definitely decent. Let's go for a boot time test with the stock OS and hardware from power button to ready desktop. (no change) 28.46 seconds. Definitely slow for today's standards. So I've got the hard disk drive out now, and we're going to replace it with this budget SSD just to keep the cost of this upgrade down. Should turn out really, really well. Always a good idea to use an SSD mounting bracket. That way you can get the SSD mounted in there exactly how the original hard disk drive was mounted previously. SSD is in and fitted like a glove. Shee! So I've got Monterey 12.6.1 installed on the new solid-state hard drive. And I mean, it's stable. You can see the menus. Everything's running really stable. I used OpenCore Legacy Patcher with the newest patch updates, October 26th, which just so happens to be today's date. So I mean, this thing is right up to speed. Okay, so let's do a quick little test on Google Chrome, which is now fully supported. Let's do the same searches as before. Let's go cooking. Definitely seems a little bit faster. Let's go houses. Fast. Technology. Everything coming up quick. Let's head over to YouTube. loads up way quicker than before. Ad pops up pretty quick. Video playback seems smooth. We're at 1080p, 60 frames per second. This is a really good test to test the stability of any graphics card in a computer. Stream 1080p and minimize and maximize while the actual video is playing. And just look for lag. Seems pretty fluid. I could see a slight touch of lag when minimizing and maximizing, but I mean, nothing crazy. Now let's do a quick boot test to gauge how quick this computer can boot on the new solid-state hard drive running the OpenCore Legacy Patcher for Monterey 12.6.1. It'll be slower than traditionally because of the patcher, but I just want to see if it is in fact quicker than the original OS X on this computer. 30 seconds. Not horrible for a computer from 2011 running the newest Monterey, but I mean, definitely not faster in terms of boot time. Transferring data via USB seems a little bit on the slower side, but I mean, it is a computer from 2011. Now we're just going to test a few apps to see how quickly they open. So let's start off with Microsoft Word, very commonly used app. Decent, but not crazy fast. Let's go ahead and open Excel. A touch faster. Definitely reasonable. Let's try Adobe Acrobat. Pretty quick. Now we're going to do a real-world test of installing Firefox and a few security plugins, just to give you guys an idea of the speed of this computer. So that downloaded reasonably quick. Let's go ahead and install it. Definitely a reasonable speed, in my opinion. Let's open up Firefox. Usually it'll take its sweet time to verify. I mean, that was pretty quick. Let's go Firefox Adblock Plus, which is a great plugin to block pop-ups and the banners that appear on the sides as advertisements in certain websites you may visit. Let's head back to extensions. Avira Browser Safety is another great one to have. Can actually detect malicious websites that you may be entering and prompt you if you'd like to continue or not. Great security feature to have. Another one is HTTPS Everywhere, which will not let you visit a site that doesn't have the secure SSL certificate. I mean, all in all, that was pretty quick. Definitely impressed with the speed of this machine. Last thing I want to share is the built-in webcam quality for a computer from 2011. I mean, Not too shabby. Definitely usable on Zoom. So all in all, can this 2011 iMac still be good in 2022? I think if you upgrade to solid-state hard drive and run macOS Monterey 12.6.1 using OpenCore Legacy Patcher, it definitely still can be. It's fast on Google Chrome, streams 1080p well, very stable, opens up apps reasonably quick for its age. Definitely a usable computer in 2022. Hope you guys found value. Hit that like and subscribe button. And as always, thanks for watching. Stay safe out there, guys.